Hello everyone, I am Swati Ghadge, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Topic for today's session is Sustainable Development. Learning outcome of this session: at the end of this session, learner will be able to explain concept of sustainable development. This is not a new concept. It appeared for the first time in 1987. Development is totally depend on source of energy or the storage of energy. Two questions immediately strike in mind when we think about availability of energy. First question is, will we have enough affordable energy for the near future? And the second question is, what will we do for the long term? There may be a many solution for this difficulty, but one of the best solution is adopt concept of sustainable development. Sustainable development is defined as development that satisfies the need of present without compromising the capacity of future generation. Sustainable development is not a fixed state of harmony, but rather a process of change. It is a way of forcing ourselves to look at factor we might rather ignore in favor of short-term benefit. For example, polluting industry that worries primarily about year's profit. These three, environment, economic development, and social development, are the pillar of development. The development in favor of environment and social development, that development is called as the bearable development. The development which is environment friendly and the in favor of economic development, that development is called as viable development. And the development which is in favor of social development and economical development only, it is called as equitable development. But the balance of these three, the balance of all these three, is very difficult and critical job. And the development which balance all these three, environment, economic development, and social development, is called as sustainable development. The uses of sustainable development is, it is guaranteeing the balance between economical growth, care for environment, and social well-being. It also find possible solution to the problem caused by industrialization and population growth. Look at this image. The half part of image is showing that there is a development, but it is environment friendly. But the overuse of energy, the over industrialization, or the population growth, that image now change. And it is turned like this. So the everywhere there is a industrialization, and see the number of vehicles. The vehicles are more than the humans. If it will continue, then there's no energy available for our next generation. So we have to minimize the use of energy, or we have to preserve the energy. And now if we adopt a concept of sustainable development, that image can be rotated again and the older days can come back. So as a civil engineer, for the sustainable development, we can do the sustainable construction, or we can construct a construction which is sustainable. So sustainable construction means what? So in the construction, use a sustainable material, that is called as sustainable construction. So what is sustainable material? Sustainable material means the material which require less use of natural resources, or and it increase the reusability of such a material for the same purpose. Now you pause video here and answer the question: what are the sources of sustainable material, and list out sustainable material. Here is the answer. Sustainable material can be available from the two main sources. First source is renewable sources, for example, plant origin, solar energy, wind energy, biogas, etc. And second source is reuse from waste. Example, old plumbing, door, crushed glass, wood chips, newspaper, old concrete. And sustainable materials are steel, glass, wood, clay, rubber, bamboo, newspaper. All these are the sustainable material. And remember, cement is not a sustainable material, but we can make it green cement by using a pozzolanic material, say fly ash, rice husk ash, that can be used as a sustainable material. First we'll see the steel. See here, in the image it is showing that all the waste metals are collected, and by recycling that can be reused. These are the prefabricated steel structure produce zero waste at site. Here this is showing that a steel frame. See here, there is no concrete wall. These are the bracing showing here that can take wind pressure or wind load. So the totally concrete wall is replaced by the steel frame. Here steel beam are there, and there is a opening. That opening provide serviceability for any type of service that can be used. Here glass and the steel are the best sustainable material, and the wide opening is filled by a glass panel so that there is no obstacle for the view outside, and all the time daylight is there in inside the room. All this picture showing that glass and steel is used in the building, and they are fulfilling the all requirements of user. Now see the waste concrete. So waste concrete can be reused. See here, the waste concrete crush primary and remove all the ferrous material. Remove all the foreign materials such as bricks, plastic, and after that again further crushing and screening of recycled aggregate into various sizes. So the aggregate can be available from the old concrete. The old concrete we cannot use as it is in the construction. It may weaken the new structure. Aggregate may use for the construction of such as wheel sleeper or road curb, and some sewage channel are showing here. So all the components which are non-structural component, for the manufacturing of such a component, that concrete can be used. So by adopting such a technology, we can save our earth, we can do the work environmental friendly, and we can preserve the energy for our new generation. These are the references for this video. Thank you very much for the listening.